After a woman heard cries coming from a tiny hole, she spent hours trying to save an animal's life. In the midst of the hustle and bustle of New York, Elysia Caris heard something. Soft cries echoed from a sliver of space beneath a gate. Caris peered inside to find a helpless animal, one she'd spent hours trying to save. Caris didn't have pets, but on October 17, 2018, she proved she had a soft spot for animals in need. On that day, the New York resident was making her way home from her job when she heard a noise. The echoing cries were soft, but after looking around, Caris figured out what they were coming from. She noticed a small opening in a crawl space beneath a nearby gate. Then she saw a tiny peach-colored paw poke out from the same hole. Caris hunched down so she could peer into the opening and see the owner of the paw. There she found a kitten, and he didn't look well. Not only was he dirty, but he also had to be cold on that chilly New York day. Unfortunately, the feline's chosen dwelling was so small that Caris couldn't slide her hand in to remove the kitten. So she headed to a nearby shop where she could purchase some food to try and entice him to come out. Neighbors then chimed in to share their observations about the kitten, and they were mostly the same as Caris's. He had hidden in this tiny shelter for weeks and barely came out, but they could all tell he needed care. So with cat food in hand, Caris returned to the gate and tried to get the kitten to leave his hole for the food he so desperately needed. But he was too frightened to come out, Caris told website The Dodo. He poked his head out and came forward just a tiny bit, but he would dart back in if a car passed or if I got too close. I stayed for about an hour trying to get him out of there before I got too cold and had to go in. I didn't want to go though, Caris said. On top of that, Caris tweeted about the ordeal and how she had already fallen in love with the feline in need. I'm trying to turn this stray kitten into a house kitten, but getting him to trust me so hard. Please let me love you. You don't have to sleep under this gate, she wrote. Eventually though, Caris had to give up on trying to save the kitten that night. In the meantime, she pushed the can of cat food into his makeshift shelter so that he could eat. In addition, it might help to rebuild a bit of strength. For the rest of the night, Caris's mind was on the frightened kitten and the connection she felt to him. I felt like he was already my cat. I just couldn't leave him there. It makes me sad envisioning him in that cold space for as long as he had been, she'd said. With that, Caris returned to the gate the following morning, determined to lure the kitten out and take him home as her own. Once again, she opened up a can of food to share with the cat, but this time she placed it in her hands. The kitten slinked toward her, moving closer and closer, Caris described. Then she said he proceeded to eat from my hands. When he finally wriggled all the way out, I scooped him up and took him home. Of course, the stray made his objections to Caris's plan audibly known. He meowed, but once she introduced him to his indoor digs, the cat appeared to calm down. He even started to purr in his new mom's arms. Caris named the cat Ying, and he quickly settled into his new environment. She too adjusted well to having an unexpected pet come into her life. In fact, just one day after bringing Ying home, she tweeted about her growing affection for him. Caris wrote on Twitter, "Crazy how in one day I went from a person with no pets to waking up to syringe feed my kitten his medicine, making sure he's pooping normally, and then obsessing over the cute sounds he makes when drinking water." To that end, Caris took Ying to the vet for a checkup to make sure he was healthy, or at least as healthy as a stray could be. The vet found some ticks on the feline's skin, and the kitten also had dirty ears. These conditions were easily treatable though, and he had no other issues. Later, Caris even reported via Twitter that she found out her cat's breed. Ying was a peach-colored tabby. "Is that not the cutest thing or what?" Caris gushed. In another tweet, she described him as the sweetest little baby. Caris's clear affection for her new pet was mutual too. According to the Dodo, the website reported that Ying appeared obsessed with his new mom and couldn't stop showing her just how grateful he was. And for Caris, that all made her two-day mission to rescue Ying worthwhile. She said, "He circles around me if I'm sitting down and rubs against my legs when he wants to be picked up. He's been by my side ever since I took him in. I feel like he's adopted me in a way."